Will you stay with me? That's how a program to make sure no one dies alone started in Oregon and has since spread across the country. Now joining us is Laura Brown to talk about this program built on compassion and volunteerism. Thank you for being here, Laura.
Well, thank you for having me. Well,
thank you. So the program we're talking about is No One Dies Alone, NODA. Can you give us some background on the program, please?
A nurse in Oregon was going around and passing her medications to her patients, and one of her patients asked her if she could stay and sit with him. She told him that she had some patients to deliver meds to, and when she came back, he had passed away. She felt terrible, and she felt that no one should be alone when they die. So she started the program of volunteers to sit with people that are close to the end of life.
That's incredible. Can you talk to us about how NODA works? What's the process?
We get a referral from the nurses, a chaplain, a doctor, a family member, anyone that wants to have someone sit with someone that is at near end of life. And our coordinator is called, and then she calls the volunteers in to sit with the patients. We sit with the patients for 2 hours at a time, and sometimes we do it one time a day, sometimes we do it three times a day, depending what the need is. And we sit usually during the times that the nurses are busy, their med passing or their change of shift. We try to cover when they can't be with the patient, we try to be there.
And this is at St. Pete's Hospital here in Helena, correct?
Yes, it is. It's at St. Pete's Healthcare, and they started in 2012.
What kind of training do the NODA volunteers receive then to be able to do this work?
We all come together and have a training, usually an evening training, excuse me, and we are instructed in how to sit with the patient, the confidentiality. Mm-hmm. The HIPAA laws are very stringent, and with us as well. Mm-hmm. And once we get finished with the training, we go up and have a practice run on how to sit with the patient and how to react to the patient.
So can you give us some examples of what volunteers are actually doing when they're sitting with the patients? I know there's different things that a patient might need or want.
A lot of patients are in a coma when we get there. Mm-hmm. Some are alert. Depending on what we find when we get there, or have talked to the family of the patient or the nurses, then we decide what we do. But usually we just sit and have a quiet presence with the patients. Sometimes we play music. We usually play a quiet harp music, unless the patient likes country western. Mm-hmm. and other things. And if they do, we try to accommodate that. But usually we just sit quietly and we talk to the patients. We might hold their hand. We assess the patient. If we think they're in pain, we go and contact the nurse, and the nurse will come in and take care of whatever is needed. We are there as a presence. It is their journey, it is not our journey. So we allow the patient to direct what we do.
So do you recruit volunteers, or how do people come to be a part of this program?
We don't recruit because word of mouth gets a lot of people involved. And we have a waiting list all the time, and we train once a year, so we keep the waiting list at that time. If someone wants to have a chance to do this program, they can call St. Peter's Health at 437-2723 and be put on a waiting list, and then the next training session they would be called.
Wonderful. So why are there times when a person would find him or herself alone at their time of their death, you know, without someone by their side?
A lot of times people have family that are far away. Mm-hmm. Maybe they don't have any family living or friends living. They're elderly, and that happens a lot. Sometimes the patients have family that are estranged, so they don't have someone that can sit with them. A lot of times we have families that can be there, but they need a break. Mm-hmm. It's a long process sometimes. Dying takes hours sometimes, sometimes days, and it gets real long for the families. So we try to be there when the family needs us to be there. If the family's not involved, we try to be there when the nursing staff needs us, when they're at their busiest times. And they are so grateful, and the families are too.
Absolutely, I can only imagine. So it's interesting, these volunteers are actually strangers to the patients that they are sitting with and giving companionship to. Do patients at all struggle with the fact that they might not necessarily obviously know this person?
We have never found that. When you go in and visit with the patient, you greet them, you tell them who you are, even if they're in a coma, you speak to them and tell them that you're there as a presence. And they relax, they enjoy it, they're thankful someone's with them.
How do you know the program's a success, the feedback you're getting from those folks you work with?
The families have sent letters, the nursing staff thanks us every time we come. Even if the patient hasn't died, they are so grateful to have someone in there with their patient so that they're not having to worry about them as they're doing their daily job.
And then maybe a few sentences. Tell us, if someone wanted to start a No One Dies Alone program in their community, what could that person do?
They can contact Sacred Heart Medical in Oregon, and they will set up a training session.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks to all my guests this morning. This week, we focused on preventing isolation and loneliness through programs where the volunteers come to you. Next week, we'll talk about how you can get out and reconnect with your community, or how you can help keep others from feeling alone. We hope you'll come back to continue this conversation with us. Until then, stay fit, stay well, and stay healthy for life with Healthy Living for Life.
Healthy Living for Life is brought to you by Mountain Pacific Quality Health. We'd love to hear from you. If you have suggestions for future programs, visit our website at mpqhf.org or call us at 406-443-4020. You can also catch us on YouTube by visiting our website and clicking on the YouTube icon. Special thanks to Fire Tower Coffee House and Roasters. Production facilities provided by Video Express Productions.